Hey, Geometry Superstars, let's take a look at the law of sines. Here we have a nice triangle, it's a non-right triangle, and I see that I have two of the angles. I can quickly find that third angle by taking 180 minus 97 minus 63, and I get a 20-degree angle for C. Now, this problem is ideal for law of sines because we have a side and we have an angle combination. We have both of the C's. And anytime you have both of the angle and the side, both of the C's, the A's, or the B's, it's ideal for law of sines. And I'll create a fraction using both of those C's. The sine of the angle is to its side, and I can do that for all of the letters. The sine of the angle A is to its side, which is baby A right up here at the top. And that's also equal to the B fraction. The sine of the angle B, that 97, is to its side, which is baby B down here. Now, for this problem, you're being asked to only find baby B. So I'm going to cross multiply. I'm not going to use the A fraction. I'm going to cross multiply this first fraction here, where I have both of them, and the third fraction over there, which is where I'm trying to find the B. So I'll just ignore this A fraction to cross multiply. The sine of 20 with the B, I write that like this, B times the sine of 20, and 10 times the sine of 97. Now, sine of 20, you touch that on your calculator, it's just a number, and you're multiplying that number with the B, so I'll figure out what the B is by dividing that sine of 20 away. And make sure you're in degree mode on your calculator. You always need to be in the right mode whenever you do trig. You'll type in 10 sine 97. I'm going to close the parentheses because I'm going to keep going. Divided by the sine of 20, and that is your baby B. 29.02001. Let's do a couple more. Number 12, you're being asked to find angle A. I've only got one of the angles, so it's kind of hard to find the other two, so I'm not going to be able to do that. But this problem is ideal for law of sines because you have both of the B's. So I'll create a fraction using both of the B's. And then I can set that equal to all the letters. The A. Sine of the angle A, I don't know it. Its side, though, is the 30. The C's, the sine of the C angle up at the top that I don't know, and its baby letter down here at the bottom that I also don't know. Now, in this problem, you're only being asked to find letter A, so I'm going to cross-multiply the first fraction here with the second fraction. I'll just ignore the C fraction. You can't cross-multiply all three. You're just going to be doing two at a time anyway. So I'll cross-multiply the sine of 30, sine of 92 with the 30, and the 35 with the sine of A. The A is the variable. I'm going to do it first. 35 sine of A, 30 sine 92. 35, I'll divide that away. Now, you can't divide the word sine. You can't subtract the word sine, but what you'll do to get rid of the sine is you'll take the inverse sine on the right-hand side over there. Now, I'm not going to try to type all that in one line. I'll type in the what's in the fraction in the parentheses part. 35, 30 part 35 times the sine of 92. And then I'll hit second sine. See how it gives me that little inverse, that little negative one. And I'll go second with my answer button down here at the bottom. And that is a 58-degree angle. 58.9392. Another problem, number 21. On 21, you're being asked to solve the triangle, so that means we're going to find everything. We have two of the angles, so in a snap, we'll be able to find the third angle down here. Let me go ahead and do that. 180 minus the 130 minus the 23. That's a 27-degree angle. And this problem is ideal for law of sines because you have the C angle and you have the C side. So I'll set up a fraction using that relationship, and I'll set that equal to the other ones. The A, the sine of angle A, well, that's 23. To its side, this baby A down here at the bottom. The B fraction, the sine of the angle B to its side. Okay? And I'll cross-multiply two of these and then get an answer, then I'll cross-multiply the other two. Please get in the habit that whenever you're finding more than one thing, that you try to start from the small to work your way up. Since this 23 is a smaller angle than 130, I know the angle or side A is going to be smaller, so I'm going to work with side A. It's not that big of a deal with sides, but it could be a big deal when you're working with angles. So get in the habit of working from small up. So I'm going to cross-multiply the first and the second. A times the sine of 27 is equal to 29 times the sine of 23. And the sine of 27, that's just a number that I'll divide quickly away from the A. And I'll write that like that right there. So I'll type that in, 29 times the sine of 23 divided by the sine of 27. So that is my baby A, 9591. And now I'll figure out what my baby B is. And to do that, I'll cross-multiply the the first fraction and the third fraction. So the sine of 27 goes with the B, just overlooking the fraction there in the middle. The 29 goes with the sine of 130. Sine of 27, that's just a number. And I'll get rid of that by dividing it to the other side. And I'll type that in. Now, let me clear off that clutter there. 29 times the sine of 130 divided by the sine of, and that's not 29 on the bottom, that should be 27 on the bottom, divided by the sine of 27. And my baby B is 48.9334. Okay? And let's do one more. Number 22. Here you're being asked to solve the triangle as well. So we're going to find the missing, looks like we have two angles. Harder to find the angles when there's two missing, but we'll do it. And we're also trying to find this baby B over here. Okay, but this problem is ideal for lost sines because you have both of the A's. So I'll set up an A fraction. I'll set up the other fractions. I'll go B. The sine of the B angle, I don't know that, is to its side. I don't know that either. So I'm not going to be able to work with that at first. I'll have to work with the A and the C. Here's the C fraction. The sine of the C angle, I don't know it, but I do know its sine. So since I don't know either B, big letter, or small letter, I'll have to work with the C over there. Where only, that's the only letter I don't have is the capital C. So I'll cross-multiply 1 and 3. Sine of 47 gets cross-multiplied with the 29. 30 gets cross-multiplied with the sine of C. That's my variable, so I'll start with it. 30 sine of C is equal to 29 sine 47. I'll take the 30 and I'll divide it away. And this is how I write that. And then I'll take the C. I can't subtract the word. I can't divide the word. I do the inverse of the sign. Now what I'll do after I find C, I'll find angle B by subtracting my angles from 180. So here's my C. Don't feel comfortable typing all that in. So here's the parentheses, and then I'll take the inverse sine of that answer, and that is my angle C, 44.9893. And I'll find out what angle B is by subtracting the angle A and the angle C from 180. So 180 minus that 44.9893. And I'll subtract away that 47, the angle A at the top of the drawing. And that is my angle B. Okay? Now to figure out what side B is, I'll go back to this fraction right here. I'm back. There's a knock at my door. To figure out the baby B, I'll take the angle B that I just found, and I'll plug that 88.0107 in for the capital B, and I'll cross multiply now finding to try to find the little b. So let me write that down again. I'll write that down here. So the sine of 47 is to 30. That's the fraction that got it all started. Is to the sine of the B. Well, I know that now. That is 88.0107 is to the little b. I'll cross multiply that and move that down a little bit. So that'll be b times the sine of 47 is equal to 30 times the sine of 88.0107. Sine of 47, that's just a number that I will quickly divide underneath to the other side. And then I'll just type that in. Baby B will be equal to, let me clear that clutter. 30 sine 88.0107, close that parenthesis, divided by the sine of 47, and that is my baby B. And I prefer to write that up here beside the drawing. So baby B is 33.649, and the 4 with the 9 bumps up to 5. Hey, I take care of yourselves. Law of sines. It's a lot of fun. Take care.